I would like to thank the viewers for choosing my particular video lecture on fluid flow. In this particular video, we are going to see a complete lecture on what is fluid flow and how it is being identified as a steady flow and an unsteady flow, and how it is being classified as laminar and turbulent flow. Before going into the actual fluid flow practices, we will understand what are the different methods in fluid flow. There are two basic methods which is being considered. One is the Eulerian method and another one is Lagrangian method. The Eulerian method talks about velocity at a particular point. Here the fluid particles are not taken into consideration, and we consider the velocity of a fluid at a particular point. We are not bothered about the velocity particle. Whereas in the Lagrangian method, it talks about velocity of a particular fluid particle. Like for a flowing stream, what happens at time at position 1? What is the velocity at position 2? So that is of a fluid particle at position. So this is a Lagrangian method. When we are trying to talk about fluid particle, we are more bothered about Eulerian method instead of Lagrangian method. So we are going to follow this particular principle, that is velocity at a particular point for a fluid. So here, before going into the actual stream, we have to understand some few parameters. The first parameter being streamline, second is timeline, and third is pathline, and next is streakline. So first we will see what is streamline. So in order to understand streamline, I am going to take a simple fluid velocity profile, and I am going to demonstrate you for a steady flow, 2D steady flow. So let's see, understand what is a 2D steady flow and what is the equation R. So this is a velocity equation which gives x into I vector minus y into j vector. Let's understand, I'll explain you why this y comes by this example. In this particular example, we'll see, say let's assume a velocity profile and plotting a velocity profile for a time period. For a time period of 0, and I am trying to plot the fluid flow particles in x and y component. So this is one example. Okay. So here what happens is the flow happens in the minus y direction towards the origin, and then it starts moving in the x direction, and slowly the velocity increases. By this graph, we'll understand how whether the velocity is increasing or decreasing. Say before go in this particular concept, if you see the velocity flow, the flow is happening only in the x direction, not in the y direction. Okay. Say for example, if I plot a tangent for this particular flow, say I have a tangent like this. I assume this is my tangent line for my profile 1, and I assume a second tangent line for my flow 2. Here when you notice this velocity profile, the tangent of the velocity profile is called the streamline. It's called the streamline, and you can find out this velocity is increasing in the x order, and it is not increasing in the y order. It means that y is an increase of time, fine, and x is the actual velocity that is taken in the consideration. So this particular equation now becomes x into t into I minus y into j. So here the time component comes into play. So this is our now we will understand what is our streamline and how the velocity profile behaves. Now, when you are trying to find the velocity component, the value of these, let's for example take this particular first profile and extrapolate the values of x and y. See, I assume x is 0.9 and y is 0.9. X is 0.9 and y is 0.9 of j. Okay. Now, to identify the actual velocity, so velocity is given by square root of x square plus y square. This is nothing but
0.9 square plus 0.9 square, which is nothing but 0.9. Similarly, I am trying to find out, say now we have found out what is the value of x, sorry, the velocity in a point, that is 0.9, 0.9. Now, in order to find the velocity profile, whether it is accelerating or decelerating, I am taking a second point whose value is x3 and y is 0.275. That is x3 and 0.275 on the particular streamline. So, if we find out the value of v, it is 3.0125. When you compare this v1 to v2, it is very, very much evident that the velocity is increased. But there is an interesting factor that we have to observe here. Though the velocity is increasing, the streamline of velocity profile 1 and the streamline of velocity profile 2 does not interlink, or it does not merge one over the other. That means even if the velocity is increased, the steady flow remains as steady flow. Okay. Now let's see the velocity profile and streamline profile for time of 1 second and time of 2 seconds. Here, I have specifically taken an unsteady flow in order to demonstrate a steady flow and unsteady flow, and the streamline difference between either of these. If you observe at t is equal to 1 second, the velocity profile, that is a white color line, is moving towards origin, and the streamline of that particular, that is the tangent of this velocity profile, again moves towards origin. But when you combinedly look into the all different velocity profiles and all the different streamlines, corresponding streamlines, it is observed that it is cornering to a point, that is, it is merging to one another, that is, it is becoming an unsteady flow. Similarly, when I take 2 seconds, you can find the velocity profile, which again moves towards the origin, and the velocity and the tangential profile, that is the streamline profile, again moves and converges towards origin. So it is very well demonstrating as that it is a unsteady flow, and by means of streamline we can identify whether the flow is steady or unsteady. I hope now you understood what is steady flow and unsteady flow by means of a simple demonstration using streamline. Okay. So now we'll move to the other topic called as timeline. Second topic that defines a fluid flow called as timeline. Here again, I'm trying to draw a velocity profile. Okay. So in order to clearly imagine this, let's assume we are introducing a bubble. Let's assume this is my water tank and I'm introducing a bubble at the bottommost surface. Okay, and the time I assume I release a bubble at the bottommost tank, and I assume the fluid is in a static condition, that is, there is no flow happening. Now when I release the bubble from this point, that is at time 0.5 second, the bubble vertically moves up. Okay. So now imagine a condition, I am inserting the same bubble at the same time, but the fluid flow is happening. So what happens here? My bubble, which is at this point, because of the fluid flow, it moves at this point because of the velocity. Because of the fluid flow velocity. Now when you plot, you will see a curve that is nothing but the velocity profile. Okay, so this we get something called a timeline. Okay, so I hope now you understood what is a timeline for a fluid that happens steady, in a steady state. Okay. Now going to the other topic called path line. And I will use another simple demonstration. Here I am considering a fluid particle. Okay. So, for example, I
assume the fluid starts at the fluid particle, that is this I consider has been started moving from this point. Say t is equal to 0 second and at t is equal to 1 second the particle has moved from this point to this point, and the curve or the path that it has followed to move from t is equal to 0 to the destination called t is equal to 1, when you plot that curve we get something called path line. Okay, so now let's understand path line behavior for a steady flow and unsteady flow. Now assume I am taking the same example, that is I am assuming particle 1 has moved to a location 1 dash, okay, at 1 second. Now I assume or introduce another particle 2 at the same point and at the same time, and I observe that particle's behavior at the second location, that is 2 dash, and it is very interesting to see that it follows the same path. Fine. So, and when you plot and the final destination of 1 dash and 2 dash, when you join, that is called the streak line, coincide one over the other. That is nothing but the path line of the first particle and the path line of the second particle superimpose one another for something called a steady flow. Got it? Hope you understood this. Now let's observe the same behavior, that is fluid particle. Let's take the same example and demonstrate for an unsteady flow. I assume particle 1, I introduce at time t is equal to 1, t is equal to 0 second, and I observe at t is equal to 1 second its position. Say this is 1 and this is 1 dash, and I observe my path line is this. Now I introduce another particle, that is 2, exactly at the same position at time t is equal to 0 second, and I observe its final destination at time is equal to t 1 second, that it has slightly deviated in its path, that is it has moved to a new location, that is 0 dash, and my new path line is this. Not to be more precise, I introduce another particle 3 exactly at the same point at t is equal to 0 second, and I observe its destination at t is equal to 1 second, and I see that it again has deviated from its original path and it has moved onto new path, that is 0 to 3 dash. Now in the steady flow what we observe is the final destination of the particle 1, that is 1 dash, and the final destination of the 2 dash is superimposing one over the other, that is the path line of the fluid particle 1 and the path line of fluid particle 2 superimpose one over the other. That is what we saw using steady flow. Now we have observed in the unsteady flow that the path does not follow the same route, that is after time is equal to t is equal to 1 second the path or the particle have gone into a new location, that is 1 dash, 2 dash and 3 dash. Now when you combine all these three we get a line that is called as streak line. Okay, this becomes path line for 3, this becomes path line for 2, and this is the path line for 1. And when you plot the end points of 1 dash, 2 dash and 3 dash, we get a curve that is nothing but our streak line. So for an unsteady flow the particle have different path lines. Okay, so in the 3-4 concepts what we have studied, that is a streamline, that is the tangent of the velocity profile, and timeline is the actual flow, the velocity component, and the path line the actual fluid particles displacement from with respect to time, and the streak line the final positions of for an unsteady flow. So having gone through all these 4, we would have understood what is a steady flow and unsteady flow. To a slightly different topic that is more related to steady and unsteady, that is laminar and turbulent flow. Laminar and turbulent These two flow are characterized by a number called Reynolds number. That is Re, which is given by, which is expressed by velocity V component into the diameter of that particular flow particle and the diameter of the fluid pipe through which the flow happens into kinematic viscosity nu. When you see this particular expression, the Reynolds number is direct related to the velocity. Now we would have also seen that the steady flow happens, the velocity also increases. Okay, so now the Reynolds, having derived the value of Reynolds number by substituting the velocity component and the diameter of the fluid flow and the kinematic viscosity, we get some numerical values, and based on that particular numerical value we can classify something called as laminar and turbulent flow by means of a number. That is, Reynolds number, if it is less than 2000, it is called laminar flow. If the Reynolds number is greater than 4000, it is called turbulent flow. Having done this, we would have got something in your mind. What if the value is between 2000 and 4000? What if it is 3000? So that flow is called as a transient flow. Okay, here what happens is, a transient flow, the flow happens or it migrates, or the flow is migrating from laminar to turbulent. That is okay, friends. Now today we have understood through this lecture video what is steady flow, what is a unsteady flow, what are the parameters in a steady flow and unsteady flow, and how do you categorize laminar and turbulent flow. Having understood this, I have developed a particular model for demonstrating it so that we clearly understand and see visually what is a laminar flow and turbulent flow. Thank you.
ஸோ இதுதான் உங்களோட லேமினர் ஃப்ளோ. நீங்கள் மட்டும்தான் உங்களுக்கு அதே ஃப்ளோ அதே செட்டப் இங்கேட்டான் டர்பலன்ஸ் ஸ்கிரீன் இடத்துல இப்போ அதே செட்டப்பு. நீ குவார்டர் டர்ன் திருப்பும் போது நான் இங்கே ஒன்றும் மாற்றலை, இந்த டையோட ஃப்ளோ வந்து அதே தான். ஆ, அதை மற்ற குவார்டர் டர்ன் திருப்பி மாற்றினேன்னா திருப்பி லேமினராக அது திருப்பி. அப்போ உன்னோட டிஸ்சார்ஜ் தான் உனக்கு லேமினார் ஃப்ளோ டர்பலன் ஃப்ளோ ரெக்கமெண்ட் பண்ணுங்க.
எல்லாமே தெரியும்.
இங்கே சம்மா கிளியரா இருக்கு சார்,
கிளியரா
நல்லா. நீ
அப்படியே பாஸ் பண்ணே, ஜூம் பண்ண
பாஸ் பண்ண, அங்கே அங்கே அதை பாஸ் பண்ண.
எடிஸ் வந்து கிரியேட் ஆகுது பாருங்கெல்லாம். அப்போ வந்து டர்புலன்ஸ் வந்து எஃபெக்ட் வருது, டிஸ்சார்ஜ் ஜாஸ்தி பண்ணுவோம் நமக்கு டர்புலன்ஸ் வந்து ஜாஸ்தி வருது. ஸோ ஃப்ளூயிட் வந்து பார்த்தீங்கன்னா ஃபுல்லாக ஃப்ளூயிட் வந்து
கரெக்டாக தெரியும். ஓகே.